Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we'll again talk about use state hook. Use state hook can be used for different reasons and different occasions, like we are initializing the state. It can also be used like you are getting some data from the APIs and then you are setting the state, right? A simple example is like you have initialized your data with an array. So this is what you are going to receive from the APIs, set data, right? And in the functional component, now we need to understand how to make an API call, right? So we already know that we can just do exios.get and all these things. But here, like in the class-based component, we are using component did mount to make an API call. Similarly, here we can use use effect. This is actually a hook we are going to talk next. This we can use actually to make an API call. This actually execute once. That depends on the dependency which you are passing. Okay, and this is what we are returning from here. So in this particular body, what we are doing is just return this. So in this body, we will be making a call. So we will understand this syntax later, but like this is some kind of API call we are making. Okay. Exios.get, you just import the exios, or you can use a fetch also. We got then we got some data. Okay, now what we can do is if you got a data, then we can set it, set data equal to data which we have received from the APIs. So it would be again data.data maybe, because data will have all the properties, and from data.data you will get the properties. Or if you are getting catch, I mean if you got any error, then you can have some kind of error handler. I will not just say it, do it in this way, because there are many better ways to handle the errors. So here error can be an object error, and here we can have set error. So here also we are using set state, and it can be empty object, and in set error you can put the error. Most probably it will be an object, and then you can access it and you can show the message somewhere, right? So this use effect, we are getting some data, and when the data is received, we are using the use state hook to update the data. Okay, we have seen this. So we are considering that this can be a kind of an array. So sometimes what happens, like we wanted to append the data coming from the APIs. We already have some data in this, some object, okay? In that case, you always can access the existing object. So here we already have a data, and here consider that we got the response. Response.data is another array we are getting. So it is like an array concatenation we are doing. Triple dot, this is another array. This is the current array. We are just merging both of them and we are getting the new array. Okay. Most of the time we have to deal with this when we are actually we don't want it to lose the previous result we already have in the state. Okay. Now, like we can just deal with the simple data, set data, and this is simple. Now we can have a create a input simple text field. Input type text. Okay, value equal to, we can say same example, and here we can have value, set value is empty array. So whenever you actually change something, so I can write on change here itself. From the event object I will access whatever is there, and I can set value e dot target dot value, right? And this value I'm trying to populate. Now there is one method which I can use here. This is update data, and what update data is doing is it is just updating this array, appending the new element which I'm adding. const update data. So in this we are just calling the set data, and what we are doing is we are appending whatever you have entered in this text field, means value. So what we can do is, this is my existing array data and value, so it will concatenate it, or you can actually push the new element onto the data, data.push new value, and then set data data. This is also fine, right? So there are multiple ways of doing the same thing, or you can access the existing state data, and what you can do is little catchy. So here we can return, this is the data we have and the new value which we got. This is also fine. So what it is doing is, it is actually getting the current array, current state array, and it just appending the new value here, and it's just a plain value, not an object. But what if you are inserting an object? Then you can just simply say, I have two things, like ID something is generated, one, and value is the value which I'm getting. So I can use shorthand, you don't need to specify both the values, something like this, right? So now data can be anything which is inside it. It's an object, I'm spreading it and then appending the new object and converting that back to an array, returning an array. So data will always be an array. And here you can loop on to the data using just a map. Here what you can do is, we haven't done this, we can just use this data. If data is there, and data will be there because data we have initialized with empty array, so you don't need to do null check here. What you can do is data.map, if there are items inside it, then we would be able to access it. You can also create and pass the index, so we can have a unique key for every child component. And from here, you can return the li. Here I can say i.value, simple i.id. You can print anything, key is also something unique, so I will put index. Okay, this is how it is working. So you can have a state as an array, state as an object, state as a boolean, state as a string, and based on your set state function, you need to manage how you are updating the state. You should not be losing the previous state. Then you can call this method, because whatever this function is going to return, that will be the new state. So you always need to be take care of this, how we are updating the state. Okay, thanks everyone.